Greetings to you all in the marvelous name of Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Welcome to Bible God Answers. I hope that these videos are helping you to understand what are the things that are going to happen in the future. Especially we are looking at the human beings and we are looking at what happens after the death. What happens after the death? We all know that. So the birth and the death is not in our hand. The birth and death of human being is not in our hand. It is in the hand of God. So what happens after the death? What happens after the death? So if you look at the Bible, how Bible describes about the death and how Bible describes about the what happens after the death. Is there something like life after the death? Or what happens exactly to the soul and the spirit which are removed from the body or which are vacated from the body, where they will go and where they will stay? And these all things are very much dealt in the Bible, and we will look into the this question: what happens after death? What happens after death? So in Christians itself, there are a lot of confusion or a lot of various opinions about this, what happens exactly after the death. So there are a lot of people who believe that there are mainly three kinds of views or three kinds of opinions on this topic name called as what happens after the death. Some Christians believe that everyone sleeps until the final judgment. So after that they will decide to, or they will destined to the heaven or hell, or they will be sending to the heaven or hell. So this is what some of the Christians believe. Secondly, there are some people who believe that instantly they will be judged after the death itself. After the death itself, the soul or spirit will be judged instantly and they will be sent into the heaven or hell. So some other guys or some other Christians believes in another view that if they die, or if the people of God or Christians die instantly, they will send into their temporary places. They will be sent into the temporary places until the final resurrection, until the final judgment. After that, they will shift from the temporary places to the permanent places. So these temporary places, they named it as the temporary heaven or temporary hell. So they will shift from the temporary heaven to permanent heaven. They will shift from the temporary hell to the permanent hell. So this is what the Christians view of what happens exactly after the death. So what does the Bible talks about? What is the Bible look? These are the three kinds of opinion in the Christendom. But when it comes to the Bible, how Bible looks at? Is there any chronological order that we can put into the practice that what happens exactly after that, after death? So what does the Bible talks about? What does the Bible talks about? Bible is very much clear or describes about the what happens after death. So there are two possible eternal destinations. There are two possible eternal destinations. We call them as the heaven or hell. Heaven or hell. So if you want to understand this question, what happens after the death? If you look at the Bible, what happens after the death? Bible describes about the two groups of people. Two groups of people. Believers, unbelievers. Believers, unbelievers. So Bible talking about the how the believers face what happens after the death. So what will happen to the believers after the death? What happens to the unbelievers after the death? What happens to the believers after the death? So these two groups of people, believers in Jesus Christ, unbelievers in Jesus Christ. So Jesus Christ is the central point over here, who decide or who divide the whole population into two groups: believers in Jesus Christ and unbelievers. So believers in Jesus Christ, unbelievers. Those who accept Jesus Christ, the people who accepted Jesus Christ, the people who did not accepted Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior. So these two people, these are also called as the righteous and unrighteous, the holy and unholy. So in that sense, where these people, where these righteous believers will go to heaven or a temporary place after the death. What about the unbelievers regarding this topic? So we will look into the first, we will look into the believers, and next we will look into the unbelievers. What happens to the believers after the death? So if you look at that question, what happens to the believers after the death? So we all know that when these people, when these believers accept Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior, so they got the forgiveness from the Lord for their sins. Their sins were carried out, or their sins were imputed onto Jesus, and Jesus died for them. So if you look at John chapter 3 verse 16, verse 18 and verse 36, so all these three verses are talking about the those who forgiven in Jesus Christ, those who accepted Jesus Christ as their personal Lord. So they will have the eternal life in heaven. So what happens exactly after the death? What happens exactly after the death for the believers? Believers will be taken into the temporary heaven. Because if you look at the Revelation chapter 21 and 22, there we can see that the new heaven and earth as heaven, as the heaven which is promised to the every believer in Jesus Christ. That is the final destination for the believers. That is the final destination. What is that final destination? New heaven and earth, which is going to be created in the Revelation chapter 21. So, according to the John 3:16 and 18 and 36, we all come to know that believers will inherit the eternal life. Believers will inherit the heaven. So if you look at the 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verses 6 to 8, Philippians chapter 1 verse 23. So if you look at these two verses, these two passages, there says that for believers, death is away from the body and being with the Lord. Away from the body and being with the Lord. So that's why Paul is mentioning over here in 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 6 to 8, Philippians chapter 1 verse 23, and in other epistles, in other letters, he was talking about the death as sleep. Those who sleep in Jesus Christ will inherit the eternal life. That's what they believe. So here, death for believers means they are away from the body. They are vacating the body and living with Jesus Christ. Here, death for believers means they are just sleeping here and rising up their eyes or twinkling their eyes in the heaven. So they are just opening their eyes in the heaven, closing the eyes on the earth and opening the eyes in the heaven. That's what for the believers. So that's why one of the believer in Jesus Christ says like this, that one of the famous saint, and he was saying that death is the open door to heaven for believers. Death is open door to heaven for believers. If you close the eyes here, we will open the eyes in the heaven. We will be with the Lord forever and ever. We will be Lord with the Lord forever and ever. So, from this point, we can come to know that believers will be with the heaven. Believers will be in the heaven, and believers will be with the Lord forever and ever. If you look at 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verses 52 to 54, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 verses 13 to 17. These two passages are talking about the souls of believers will be resurrected. The souls of believers will be reunited with the physical body. So the death for the believers, if the believer died, the physical body remains in the grave. So it remains in the earth, and the soul and spirit will be with the Lord. So when Jesus came unto the midday, when he is going to come in the second coming, when Jesus came unto the midday, he will come along with the souls or the spirits of the believers, those who believe in him. He will come along with them and he will send those souls or spirits to the graves where they were buried, where they were buried. So when these souls or spirits are reunited with physical body, they will be resurrected with the resurrected body, or they will be resurrected with the glorified bodies. They will be resurrected with the glorified bodies. So this is what the resurrection of believers will happen at the rapture of the church. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 verses 13 to 17. So 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 50 to 54. What happens at the rapture of the church? The dead in believers, the dead believers in Jesus Christ, those who sleep, those who fallen asleep in Jesus Christ, they all will be rise up. They all will be resurrected with the glorified bodies, and this physical body will be reunited with the soul and spirit which came from the heaven, and they will be having the resurrected body. They will be having the glorified body. This glorified body is very much necessary, very much necessary. What is the need of this resurrection? If the souls or spirit of the believers will be the Lord in the heaven, then what is the need of this resurrection? Then what is the need of this? What is the purpose of this resurrection? So what is the purpose of this resurrection? This resurrection is also called as the believer's resurrection, because all the believers will be resurrected in this resurrection. And this is also called the first resurrection. This is also called as the first resurrection. All the believers who are resurrected in this first resurrection will be inherited the new heaven and earth. So this glorified bodies means it is nothing but those bodies will not have the pain. Those bodies will not have the death. So those bodies will not have this kind of diseases. So those bodies will not have the death. So those bodies will not have the death. So that's why this body has the death. That's why we are dying. We are having the natural death. So, but when it comes to the glorified bodies, those glorified bodies will be like this only. Will be as Jesus Christ has risen from the grave or risen from the dead. So in the same manner, we are also will be resurrected as Jesus Christ resurrected in the first century. In the same manner, these resurrected bodies or these glorified bodies will going to be inherited, will going to be spend their eternity in new heaven and earth. In new heaven and earth. That's why these glorified bodies or this physical body should be resurrected with the glorified body. So from this point of view, we can come to know that the believers in Jesus, those who accepted Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior, if they die, so death is for everyone. Death comes from the Adam's sin. So Adam's sin, that were death as a consequence of sin, came onto the whole world, came onto the whole humanity. So from this point of view, we can understand that these believers, after they die, they will be with the Lord at the temporary heaven. They will be with the Lord at the temporary heaven. So this temporary heaven are called as the paradise. So this temporary heaven is also called as the paradise, and it is also called as the third heaven. So that's why Paul says that I went to the third heaven. I saw myself at the paradise. So he was talking about the paradise and third heaven. So this temporary heaven will be the paradise, and the third heaven, it will be in the third heaven. So we all know that there are three heavens that are described in the Bible: first heaven and second heaven and third heaven. First heaven is the atmospheric heaven or atmospheric sky, where we are having the birds and the sky creatures. So where we can see, but beyond that there is a space. Beyond that there is a space. In that space there are nine planets. So planets or Milky Ways or different kind of galaxies are presented over in the second heaven. We cannot know, or Paul did not give any a geographical location for the third heaven. So we all could not know that where this third heaven is there. But in the third heaven, there is paradise. So this third heaven is also called as the living place for the heavenly beings. So from this point of view, you can come to understand that these believers are kept in temporary heaven until their souls and spirits will be reunited with their physical bodies. So they will be waited in the temporary place. They will be waited in the temporary heaven. So that's all about the believers in Jesus Christ who will inherit the temporary heaven at present, and they will be shifted from the temporary heaven to the permanent heaven when the new heavens and new hell were created in the Revelation chapter 21. So when we look at the another side, the unbelievers in Jesus Christ, those who did not receive Jesus Christ as their savior. So those who did not receive Jesus Christ as their savior, those who did not accept Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior. So for them, the death means everlasting punishment for their souls or spirits. So death means everlasting punishment. That's what the Bible talks about, and it talks about that the death for the unbelievers is the eternal punishment that they are going to experience in the hell. So the permanent place or the final destination for unbeliever is hell. The final destination for unbelievers is hell. That is the final destination. So if you look at Luke chapter 16 verses 22 to 24, there we can say that the rich man was tormented. The rich man was punished in the place of judgment and condemnation. So here they called it as the pit. Here they called it as the Sheol. So they called it as the Sheol. Sheol, pit. So they called it as the Sheol. It means this rich man. So this rich man and the Lazarus was with the Abraham. Lazarus with the Abraham. So Abraham and Lazarus are in the paradise, and this rich man is in the pit or Sheol. So where their souls were tormented, where their souls were punished, where they were in the place of judgment and condemnation. So it means after the unbelievers, if they die, they will be in the temporary hell. Because this rich man went to the temporary hell, which is also called as the pit or Sheol. So it means they were tormented over there. They were tormented over there. So they were punished over there. They have some kind of pain in their souls and spirit. So from this point of view, we can come to understand. And in Revelation chapter 20 verses 11 to 15, in that passage, we can come to understand this. All the unbelievers will be resurrected. All the unbelievers will be resurrected, and they will be presented at before the great white throne judgment. The great white throne judgment. So once the judgment is done, they will be sent into the lake of fire. So it is also called as the hell. It is also called as the second death. So the first death is natural to everyone. It comes to the everyone. But when it comes to the second death, where the souls and the spirits are oriented with the physical body, and this resurrected and glorified bodies will be cast out in the lake of fire, where the judgment and condemnation is prevailed over there, where the punishment was very much severe. So there the people are crying, or there the people were tormented. So from this point of view, we can understand that all these unbelievers, after the death, they will be sent into the temporary hell. They will be sent into the temporary place where they were tormented, where they were punished, where they have some kind of pain due to the punishment. It means they are sending into the temporary hell. So the permanent hell is the final destination for the unbelievers. But until the resurrection of their bodies, their souls and the spirits will be tormented, will be having some kind of pain due to the punishment at the temporary hell, due to the punishment at Seol. So from these two points we can understand, for believers after the death, their souls and spirits will be in the temporary heaven. It is also called as the paradise. So when it comes to the unbelievers, they will, after they die, they will be sent into the temporary hell. It is also called as the Sheol, or it is also called as the pit. So these two are temporary places. Once all these souls or spirits are reunited with their physical bodies and having that resurrected bodies or glorified bodies, and they will be shifted from these temporary places to the permanent places. So here all the unbelievers will be sent into the permanent heaven, and permanent heaven where new heavens and earth created. So when it comes to the unbelievers, they will be sent into the permanent place, that is heaven, that is hell. So for believers, temporary heaven and later shift into the permanent heaven. For unbelievers, temporary hell and they will be shift into the permanent hell. That is also called as the lake of fire. It is also called the second death. So until the resurrection of their bodies, they will be kept in temporary places. This temporary place is called the paradise. For believers, temporary place is called the paradise. And for unbelievers, the temporary place is called as the Sheol, or the pit. These two. So we got the very much clearance what happens after the death. When comes to the believers and when comes to the non-believers or unbelievers. When comes to the believers, they will be sent into the temporary heaven. When comes to the unbelievers, they will be sent into the temporary hell. So after their resurrection, there will be judgment. After the judgment, they will be sending into their permanent places. So there is no change in their places, but they were shifted. So that's why here the opportunity was given to every one of us. So that's why if you look at 2 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 2, it is says, behold, now is the favorable time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. Behold, now is the favorable time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. Here is the good news for every one of us. Here is the good news for you guys. Here is the good news. Jesus Christ died for you, for the sake of you, your sins and my sins, and he died on the cross of Calvary to give the eternal life, which your soul and spirit will be reunited with the physical body and will have the resurrected body and have the glorified bodies, and they will be shifted from the temporary heaven to the permanent heaven. So my dear friends, through Jesus Christ only we got the heaven. Through Jesus Christ only we got the salvation. So here, that's what Jesus says, that I am the way, the truth and the life. If you believe in Jesus Christ, if you accept Jesus Christ, you will be with the Lord. If you don't accept Jesus Christ, you will not be with the Lord. So there are only two places. There are two eternal destinations. Two temporary destinations are there. Two eternal destinations are there. Two temporary destinations are there. Two permanent destinations are there. So if you decide now itself, there itself only, you can get the salvation through Jesus Christ. Here is the golden opportunity. Through Jesus Christ, do you want heaven? If you don't accept Jesus Christ, you will be sent into the hell. This is the fact in the Bible. Accept Jesus Christ and receive the salvation, receive the eternal life, who it is will be a pleasurable life, and which will be a happy life with heaven, with the Lord. May the Lord give this salvation, give this eternal life those who are in his will. Thank you.